If you need a new or better way to visualize or just work with your Airtable data, there's a good chance that there is an app for that. If you've not already become a pro Airtable user and you've never used an Airtable app, in this video, I'm going to be going into all the detail about how the apps work, how you can install them, and what they're going to help you accomplish. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Hey, welcome back to the channel. My name is Gareth, and if you're new here, I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, where we help you to organize and automate your business. If that's of interest and you want to learn more about that, check out the links in the description of this video. And don't miss our upcoming free live webinar, where I teach the basics of automation so that you can reclaim your time and focus more on the stuff that matters instead of doing that repetitive admin work. So, if you're interested, check that link below, garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration to get signed up for that next live training. And even if you can't attend the actual training, don't worry about it. We're going to send you a replay. But without further ado, let's get into the heart of this video. We are talking about how to use apps. So I know for a lot of you, you haven't actually made the plunge and upgraded to that pro Airtable account yet. And that's totally cool. I was there for a while myself, not sure if it was worth it for me to pay for the pro plan. One of the biggest advantages to the pro plan, though, is that you get the apps. And apps are going to help you do a lot of different things inside of your existing database. So let's jump in. I'm going to walk through how to set up an app, what all of this means, and make sure you stick around until the end, because at the end of this video, I'm going to be going into what I hope to see for apps in the future. So let's jump into my screen here. The first thing you need is to make sure that you're on that pro plan. Now, the plans, the paid plans, are going to be unique for each workspace. And a workspace is just like a folder of databases, right? So I've got this workspace here, which is a paid plan, and then I have other plans below that are not paid. So if I were to go into my free plan, for example, into any of the databases in that free plan, and I try to add an app here on the right-hand side, you're gonna see that when I pick any app, it's gonna say that I have to upgrade. Right, so this is, again, one of those features that you're only gonna get if you're on the pro plan of Airtable. If I go in here, it says, look, you have to upgrade to pro in order to get the superpowers of Airtable apps. Now, this in and of itself is okay, but the part that really does bum me out is that for any other apps that were made by outside organizations, not just Airtable, right, because there are a bunch of different apps that have been built by other third parties, well, I also have to be on that Airtable Pro plan to install those apps as well. And we're gonna go into detail on this when we go, you know, step by step setting up an app ourselves. But if I were to install, let's say, Quick Charts app QR Code Maker here, you see that I can't do that without upgrading first. And this, in my opinion, is a bummer because it's handcuffing the developer who built this app and saying, well, you know, sorry, but we're not going to make your app available unless the user is already a pro paying Airtable user. So again, we're going to get more on that. And as I already mentioned, I'm going to talk at the end about what I hope to see for apps in the future, and I'm already kind of teasing it. So let's just jump into setting up an actual app, understanding that we have to be in a paid plan. A pro Airtable plan must be used. Now, this particular database is already in a pro plan, so no problems there. We can install whatever app we want. All we do is click on add an app from the right-hand app panel, and we're going to see, again, marketplace apps up at the top, and we have four different fields right now, or filters that we can kind of thumb through. Now, featured is pretty self-explanatory. These are those apps that Airtable is currently featuring or putting up at the front. This changes every so often, maybe once a quarter or thereabouts. And of course, there's no set timeline there. So hey, if somebody releases a new cool app, perhaps it gets pushed to the top of this list and gets featured so that more people can adopt it. And that's just better for everybody. But this is what's up there currently. Now, these apps are no different than the apps on these other tabs back here as well. So the way these are broken up, apps by Airtable, as you would expect, were all built by Airtable. And a little bit of Airtable history over the last few years, these were the original apps. Now, originally, outside developers, third-party developers, couldn't build apps and make them available in the marketplace. So previously, we only had those apps that Airtable built themselves. And the vast majority of the apps that Airtable has built are just really great ways to help us visualize our data in our database. And we've done countless videos on this before where we showcase how you can use a bar graph, for example, to look at sales month over month, or use a pivot table to slice and analyze your data in a number of ways. You have a bunch of different apps, and some of these also connect to third-party tools like SendGrid. If you want to send mass email directly from your Airtable base and you have a SendGrid account, then you can install this app that was built by Airtable to leverage the power of SendGrid email marketing. So there are a number of different apps, and of course you can scroll through these at your own leisure. And of course, if you have a particular one that you're looking for, you can just type it up here in the top. Let's say I was looking for the chart app. I can just start typing that and I get Gantt chart, flow chart, organizational chart, and three other ones that apparently have the word chart in them somewhere. So that's it for the Airtable apps. But now, as I mentioned, Airtable has opened up its app platform, if you will, its marketplace, to third-party developers. And so by clicking on the All Apps option, you can see all of the different apps that other people have built as well. And sometimes these other people are actual third-party companies in the example of Typeform. So Typeform, if you're unfamiliar, is a form software that's out there. And if you were to install the Typeform app, you could do so. Of course, you need to have a Typeform subscription, so it was worth Typeform's time to build this app in Airtable. But this will allow you to do better things between Airtable and Typeform. So in this particular case, you can create forms in Typeform, and you can also import data from Typeform forms and get it into an Airtable database. So really cool way that you can interact with these softwares. So as I said, a lot of third-party software companies have actually built apps for Airtable that allow you to get more out of the synergy between these software. Now, some of the apps in the All Apps section don't necessarily come from third-party software companies, but just from low-code or no-code developers who think that Airtable's missing something in particular, and so they decided to build it. So let's take a look at just one of those. So specifically, I know QR Code Generator here. This was built by Little Appy Co. And if we were to go in here, you can see in the notes before installing the app that this app actually requires an ongoing subscription. And this feature is rising in popularity among the Airtable app developers because a lot of people are starting to say, well, why would I put forth the effort of building a really cool app that allows users to do more in Airtable without receiving anything for it, right? At this point, if they just put it out there on the Airtable app marketplace without any kind of paywall or subscription model, then that's it. And so a lot of developers have started to get savvy to this. And again, this is kind of bleeding into where I hope apps is going to go in the long term, but I don't want to get ahead of myself. So let's go ahead and just install an app, any old app, and just walk you through how you get that set up. So for example, let's say you had an org chart or you had the need for an org chart. Well, this particular app is built by Airtable. You can, of course, contact the publisher and see the support documents here on the side. And this little piece will give you a blurb on what this app is going to help you do. So if you add the app, all it does is it takes 5 seconds or so, and it just installs it here. And then depending on what that app is, it's going to have some queries here on the side where it's asking you to get it synced up and all connected. So it's going to ask you, what table does your data live in? What view should I be looking at in order to produce this output for you? And what's the relationship field? This is unique to this particular app, the org chart. So let's imagine really quickly that we had an organization, and I'll just fill out some data here, and we can see how the org chart allows us to then visualize that data in a new and creative way. Let's say, for example, we just have Gap Consulting's team. I have myself, Matt, Connor, and I'll pick on one of our other developers, Allie. So in this case, we might perform some sort of a hierarchy and want to list the manager of each person. So I'll build a linked relationship to the same table here, table one, and we're just going to create a link to the manager. So we could say, well, Matt, might report to me, Connor might report to Matt, and Allie might report to Matt as well, let's say. Well, now if we go into our org chart app, we can open this up. And again, we have to map it out, right? So we say, well, what table does our data live in? We only have the one table. What view are we looking at? We only have the one view. And what relationship field? In this case, it's the manager. That's the link. And you see that in doing so, it now is mapping out our data really nicely in a new way that we can visualize. Now, in our case, we said this is the manager, not the employee. So we might flip this around and say relationship type parent. And then that turns the organization around. So yeah, we can see that Gareth is here, then Matt, and then Connor and Ali reporting to Matt. And of course, if we make any changes to the data structure, let's say Ali starts reporting to Gareth instead, we can take this out and replace it here. And then we see on the side that our org chart is updated in real time. So again, a lot of these apps really just help us to visualize our data in new ways and or do other fun things with it that would otherwise maybe take us some extra steps. So for example, you have the CSV import capability, or as I already talked to, the ability to send mass email through SendGrid from your Airtable base. So this is just a small taste, but again, if you're not already on that pro plan, you probably haven't had the ability to see these apps in action. And so there are a lot of really great things to do here. And of course, the last piece before moving on to what I hope to see with apps in the future, the last piece to talk to is the scripts. And the scripts is where we've gone from being a no-code environment inside of Airtable to being a low to medium code environment. So a lot of the time, there are just those more advanced things that you want to be able to do with your data. And unfortunately, you have to turn to code at some point. And so scripts allow you to actually build a script with some code there inside of your database that can run based on certain conditions and give you even more advanced features. Again, though, this is not for the faint of heart. This does require a certain level of coding knowledge. So that's it for how apps work. Let's talk though about what I hope to see with apps in the future. Now, bear in mind, I'm just one person, so this is just one person's opinion. But what I really hope to see is a better relationship and a better synergy with the developers who are building these apps for the Airtable marketplace. If you think about it, Airtable basically got to a point where they said, we can't possibly build all of the apps that people are going to want. Why don't we open up our marketplace? This reminds me a lot like, you know, what Apple did when it started to have its marketplace for apps as well, and what Google Play now has and all of that. I wish that there was a better way that the developers were getting compensated, because as I showed you, some developers have started to build off their own subscription models and say, hey, you can only use this app if you're paying me directly. But what I would really love to see Airtable do is actually bake that price into the subscription model for the people using the apps. So at the time of recording this, Airtable charges, I think, $24 a month per user on the pro plan. Well, if you installed, let's say, an app that was built by Acme Company, maybe Acme then would get the opportunity to price that app at $3 per user. And so if a person installed it who had four users, then of course they'd be charged $12 more automatically on their Airtable monthly bill. This way they don't have to worry about having a different bill with Acme Co., but instead they would just pay for all their different apps there inside of their Airtable subscription plan. And of course, Airtable would give a cut of that additional bonus part to the developer for those various apps. This is what I would love to see in the long run, and it would really be basically like having an Apple Store or the Google Play Store here inside of Airtable apps. I think that if Airtable were to actually take this step, it would only further encourage developers to play in this sandbox, and therefore they would get bigger and badder apps from the community. Let me know in the comments below if you agree with that thought or not, and also which of these apps are your favorites, and I will see you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts, we have some online courses and a group coaching program, and for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.